In order to get regular tips on health and general wellness, especially the natural way, please click on the subscribe button on the right side of this video. This will ensure that you also get notifications anytime a new video is posted on this channel.
It is important that we follow me carefully with the story I'm about to tell. I'm going to start today's presentation with a short story. And the story is going to be what I'm going to round up with. It's a short story that lets us know how medicine has evolved over the years and how a lot of things have changed in those years. So it all started in the 20th century with a man named John D. Rockefeller, who lived in 1839 to 1937. John D. Rockefeller was an oil magnate. He's a rubber baron. He's an American first billionaire. He can be the version of our own Dangote of now, but so much more. He's a natural born monopolist. He's really very rich. He has his hand in a whole lot of things. He's the owner of Standard Oil, that is now broken down to Chevron, Exxon Mobil. John D. Rockefeller controlled 90% of all American oil refineries as at then. So you can see how powerful he was. So around 1900, petrochemicals were discovered, and they found out that you can actually make a whole lot of things from petrochemicals. You can make a lot of products involving drugs and all from petrochemicals. So they had the problem at then that, okay, this is an opportunity. John D. Rockefeller owns the oil, so he wants to try to monopolize every other fuel he can using the oil. And scientists are coming up with different type of experiments that shows you can actually make drugs from oil and make a lot of vitamins and a whole lot of other things from it. But as at then, in 1900, everything was around about medicine. Even in medical schools, they were teaching homeopathy, they are teaching a whole lot of science involving herbal prescription. As at the way they learned it from Europe and all other countries then. So it was basically herbs and a lot of things that were being prescribed. The modern medicine we know now was not there. So this is a big problem for John D. Rockefeller. He wanted something that is going to make him to monopolize the whole medical industry. So what did he do? He went to a friend of his called Andrew Carnegie. So Andrew Carnegie started the foundation. Through this Andrew Carnegie's foundation, John D. Rockefeller and Andrew Carnegie employed a man called Abraham Flexner. This Abraham Flexner gave birth to the favorite and what redefined medicine up to now, something called the Flexner's report. So what did Flexner do? Flexner knew that, okay, for them to be able to change the way medicine is being done, they need to find a way to condemn everything that has been done. And in condemning it, they have to still make a way of making others to look inferior. So he started a journey that took him through all the medical schools. Then there were over 65 medical schools in America. So they went there, they looked at all the things they were doing, and really, there are a lot of substandard things being done then. So they want to unify everything medicine is doing, so that it's not going to be the same thing anymore. What Flexner now did is that he now wrote a detailed report after going through all the medical school, because there was nothing guiding, there was no principle, everybody was just doing whatever they want to do. So it was Flexner, who is not a medical doctor, that now wrote a report and said how medicine is going to be done, that any medicine that does not have a research and evidence based is not going to work, that whatever it is that any medical person wants to practice has to be properly documented, has to be researched. So they draw up a curriculum for every medical school, and that is what they are going to follow. And they set up a board that called General Education Board, where they are financing all the medical schools with over $100 million at then. That's quite a lot of money. So they now employed scientists to start making research on herbal products. All the key chemicals that they find in these herbal products, they now replicate them using their own petrochemical products to produce that same chemical. and end up now condemning the herbs where they get these things from. So for example, now maybe you determine, you find that this thing is, for example, you determine that this particular this is the particular compound that is working in this leaf. They replicate it using chemicals and they condemn the leaf that they make all those things from. They did that because they want to create a monopolistic market. And before you know it, every medical doctor stop learning about how nutrients, how herbal and all those things can be of use for you. Rather, they focus on those petrochemicals. And Carnegie and Rockefeller were smart. They weren't focusing on healing. They were not focusing on curing. They were focusing on symptomatic management of all these diseases, so that when you use it, you keep coming back. So it's only the symptoms that was being treated and not that the disease were being cured. And they gradually killed this herbal that this thing is coming from, because then those people don't know on how to do research. They are just using it. They don't have dosage. They don't have anything, just like what we have now. So they were able to be smart enough to kill the herbal completely and take the chemical apart to produce all the drug that we know as of now. So this is what Flexner's report has done, and that is what killed herbal medicine in those days, and the modern medicine we know came into life. So after establishing this story, I'm going to start the presentation properly. What do we need to be afraid of? What should we be afraid of? He said that 17.7 million, almost the whole population of Lagos State, have died from cardiovascular disease every year. So this is about 31% of all global deaths. That means all over, if you look at it, the entire Lagos State have probably died from cardiovascular disease. And there are many other ones, like infection, COPD, diabetes, cancer, and a lot. Then 95% of the overall population live in one ailment or the other, and some of them even have comorbidities. That means you might have hypertension, I have diabetes, I have the whole lot of all these things together. So is this not enough for us to be afraid of? And we keep seeing a whole lot of emerging diseases. New diseases are coming, whereas one of it is this coronavirus that we are talking about now. The coronavirus is not a new thing. It's the COVID-19 that is new. Coronavirus contain of SARS, MERS, and this common flu. Just that this COVID-19 is just a species of it that probably has modified or something. So scientists are really struggling with challenges to create cure to all those things. Most of all these diseases don't have cure, and it has been like that. So scientists are really struggling. And new pathogens that we can really treat successfully, we cannot treat them again because they are developing resistance. There have been so many things about augmenting, about Zenith and this whole thing now, that resistance are fast developing, and if you are not careful, they are not going to work again. And pollution is another thing. It's increasing by the day with all these new discoveries of science and all. Pollution is beginning to be a big problem, and is impacting on all of our health globally, not just in Nigeria, everywhere. It is actually a serious thing. So we have these emerging diseases that are coming that we don't even know how we are going to handle them yet. This COVID-19 has showed us where we are with all the research the whole world has done so far. That means we are still so short of so many things. So if you are not scared before, this is the time for you to get being scared. Hepatitis C recently can be cured. B cannot be cured. Hypertension cannot be cured. Scientists are anticipating so many new diseases coming. A lot of them are coming. A new disease that were not previously predicted before are still going to come. A lot of mental illness don't have cure. A lot of every other thing don't have cure. So if you are not scared before, this is actually the right time for us to be cured, to be scared. So is there a solution to this? Yes, there can be solution. Orthodox medicine is doing a lot of active research all the time. And despite the fact there are still so many diseases, so what cure can we do about this? Is there any remedy about herbals? Forefathers, they depend on herbs for most of the treatment that they do. If you look at our flora and our fauna, there are a lot of herbal things there that we have not even explored, that we have not even gotten into at all. So is there anything that we are going to tap from here? All this technology that we have, can we critically look at these things and standardize this technology and make something good out of it? And that is why we are here. That's the reason why we are discussing what we want to discuss today. Are there some potent substances that we have neglected that is going to help us in these changing times when we have seen that science is already failing us? Yes, there are a lot of them. Quinine, as you know it, it comes from cinchona. Artemisinin comes from artesia. Penicillin comes from penicillium. All these are herbs. All these are trees. That the key ingredient in them has been able to be synthesized by scientists, just like what John D. Rockefeller and Carnegie did, that they were able to replicate this thing and patent them. Like I said, that recently someone just patented the so-called efirin that we've all known, on ewuro, rather, not ewuro, that's bitter leaf. Someone in America patented it. Most of us grew up knowing this ewuro, but because there's no research getting it, it was not patented. And now someone has the rights in America that he owns ewuro. This is what we all know. So that is what is happening. Orthodox medicine can actually key into what we have in herbal and develop it, not discarding the herbal itself, but redefine it to know the safe dosages, redefine it to know the effectiveness, and redefine it to know the limits. Instead of discarding it, we can actually move and fly with it. And a new world order is being created. For example, in Asia now, a lot of propaganda, which I don't know how true it is happening about the origin of this COVID-19, the 5G technology and all. So if this is true, a new leader of the world is going to be born, and that's going to be in Asia. And we can see Asia is unapologetic about our products. They've been using the herbal medicine for so long, though they have some other orthodox thing that they do, but they are not apologizing about them using the herbal products at all. Ginseng is a key thing that we use in medical as an adjunct. John Watts and Valeria and some other things that you can actually be used in management of some certain cancers, and this, they don't have any side effect, or they have very minimal side effect. So if the new order is coming and Asia is going to come to the forefront of leading the world, you can be rest assured that they are going to bring the herbals with them. So we have something in our hand now that we too can actually develop. Asians are being very smart, because now, especially China, now they are really doing a lot of partnership with Africans. They are trying to help Africans because they have seen some other key things that they are going to benefit, that we have in our land and we are not making proper use of. So this is an opportunity for a new world order to be created, and for us to key and belong into that new order with our own herbal products. What is oxidative stress? Oxidative stress is basically an imbalance between free radicals and antioxidants in the body. Simple. It's just the imbalance between antioxidants and free radicals. That is what gives birth to. The body goes through oxidative stress every time. Either from the food we eat, either from the exercise we do, either from the things we don't do, either from us just sitting bound, being sedentary and not exercising. Regularly, oxidative stress is happening in the body at every point in time. So that is oxidative stress. And all the concept of oxidative stress has been able to be shown to have affected every disease in the body, from the head to the toe, from heart to the eyes, to the liver, to the kidney, everything oxidizes. Recently, I got to find out that even in infertility, there's something we call endometriosis, that if you take care of oxidative stress alone, a woman that was not able to give birth will be able to give birth. So that concept of oxidative stress is what scientists have been able to see so far, that it is responsible for why herbals do what exactly they do so well. Although a lot of research is still ongoing and so many things is still going to be known, but the concept of oxidative stress is what makes herbals to be able to do what they do. I'm going to get a little bit scientific, so I need us to follow me carefully. So I mentioned some key terms. I said antioxidants and free radicals. So what radicals are substances that exist on their own in a very unstable form. That means they have an imbalanced form of electron. So let's just picture something that is uneven. Even numbers are 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 2, 4, 6, 10, like that. Even numbers, we know them. So when free radicals exist and they are uneven, they now become unstable. And when they are not stable, they tend to want to react with everything they see in the body, especially in the cell. They tend to want to react with everything they see so that they can become stable, because they themselves are not happy that they are not stable. So, and these free radicals are giving birth to all the time, as we are eating, as we are drinking, as we are exercising, we keep having the free radicals all the time. So every time they want to stabilize themselves, they look for every other cell and attack the cell so that they can drag an electron away from that cell. They want to drag an electron so they can stabilize. As they are dragging this electron away from those cells, they are making the cell to grow old. The cell is getting old. The cell is not stable again. The cell is malfunctioning and it can destroy the cells. Because as they are taking away the electron from those cells, taking away the electron, and this is what accounts to almost every disease, including aging in the body. I'm going to find and see if I have a picture that shows what happened to the cells when it is going through the effects of free radicals. So we can see this picture that I dropped above. You can see the normal cell. The normal cell was attacked by free radicals, and the free radicals destroyed it, and the concept of positive. So what are antioxidants? So antioxidants are substances that are ready to donate their own electrons to free radicals without them getting stable. So for example, now the cell has been attacked because the electron is being taken away from it, but antioxidants will come and give those cells away happily. And when they are giving away those electrons, they don't get angry, they don't get unstabilized, they are stable, they are happy doing it. They are donating to the body to make the body to be stable, and they keep giving it away. So imagine when you have millions of cells that are destroyed, like that other slide I dropped, and then there's an antioxidant that is giving these things back to the system. So that means the oxidative stress will not happen. The cells is going to look healthy. The person will look young. If the disease has resulted in any, if the concept of this oxidative stress has resulted in anything, it's going to get killed and the person gets fine. So that is what antioxidants basically do. So now I'm going to move to the reason why we are here today, which is our product, Rida Herbal Bitters, our first product that we came out with, and a potent antioxidant. And send our letter. So those are the five components of the Rida Herbal Bitters, and all of them, what they have in common is that they are all potent antioxidants. Do much of our time. What all of them, what they do is already written in the slides that I pasted above, so we can read through to see what they do, apart from them being an antioxidant. And the reason why they do what they do is what the good thing about this thing is that we have research to back all these things that we are doing. A lot of research has been done. The toxicity level has been assessed. The safety on the liver, the kidney, the spleen, and all those things are done. We have publications that are coming in journals. Currently, the publication on Rida Herbal Bitters is done on the World Journal of the Pharmacist World Journal. Something going on for us right now. So when people tell us that maybe what we are doing does not have any background, we have research to show that these things are well researched. It's not just something that we just made up, that okay, this thing is working for this, and that's what differentiates this. Rida being a potent antioxidant, it donates nitrogen oxide to the body, and the evidence of what nitrogen oxide does is that my voice note is cutting in between. I don't know why it's doing like that. So the nitrogen oxide on its own does a whole lot of other things, like it improves. So the nitrogen oxide does a lot of other things. Improve the oxygen delivery to every cell. It expands the blood vessels. It improves overall. It helps regulate your blood pressure. It improves erectile dysfunction. And that is the reason why we have testimonies of all these things we have about Rida Herbal Bitters. A whole lot of every other thing. So that establishes why Rida does what it does. So I'm going to stop that on Rida. Okay, so I'm going to conclude the Rida brand itself as our bitters on this basis. These are the things Rida does, and they do it so effectively. One, it donates nitrogen oxide from outside the body to augment local production in a sustainable manner. Rida demonstrates extensive antioxidant activity. That's number two. Rida creates health enhancing synergistic effects, and Rida relieves irritation in the system. This things make it to be able to act significantly on the brain. The brain is give us memory, alertness, mental alertness, capacity and cognitive function. It improves all these things. Then, apart from that, the effect of the nervous system too, it cannot be overemphasized. That's why some people see that when they take it, they see that they are more alert, they can perform better at work, and they can do so many other things. So those are the things that Rida do. So now I'm going to round up with that and move to the Rida variants. Those are the other products that we have. First variant I'm going to be talking about is the Rida Balm. The Rida Balm contains a whole lot of things. One of the components is Coagulopyrrolosa, then eucalyptus oil. So a lot of research have been done on eucalyptus oil and pylosat so that we cannot overemphasize what they do in the body. And this balm has been so effective. I've had testimonies of people traveling and they're having pain, they rub it and the pain disappears. They are having form of arthritis, they use it, it is gone. They are having nasal congestion, they use it, it is gone. So we have a wonderful product in this Rida balm. So it's not, I tell people that you don't compare this to rub. This is different from rub. This is what you look at, things that does much more than things like all those neurogesic balm, all those things that we rub. It has so many effects than all those things because of the herbal constituents or it has inside it. So it's something that we should prescribe with confidence because it actually works. When your product is working, it markets itself. And this balm has done that over and over again. And I believe this balm should be one of our most trusted products outside there because it's really, really very efficacious.
Thank you.
So the above are the components of the remaining of our other variances. So those things are quite effective. You can go through the components to see what they contain. And I can assure you, these are not just products that are just done because we want to mix something together. These are products that have been well researched, and they are top-notch in whatever space that they are playing, be it infertility, be it the fire, be it the restore for women. I still got the testimony about restore yesterday. So we have a wonderful product with us, and we have been able to prove why these things do what they do. So on this note, I'm going to be rounding off this presentation, and right now it's actually very important for us to know how to talk about this product, because when you are going into this space and you want to talk about product to people, they are going to ask a lot of questions, that how come this your product does this, especially the bitters. People will tell you that, is it gbogbo onise, why is it doing this, why is it doing that? But now if they say it is gbogbo onise, we can explain the reason why it can do this. This is why it's basically because of it being an antioxidant. An antioxidant affects everywhere in the body, so that's why the Rida bitters does that. Then the variances, it's just like, okay, let's say we want to specialize in this particular field. So not that it's going to do everything, but it is more for this. This is more for this. Fire is for this. Restore is for this. Balm is for this. Fat burner is for this. And the function are still interwoven. There are some people that I know that during infertility, they will still use the cleanser. The cleanser that we know that is used for yeast infection and to treat yeast balance and infection in the body. It has antibiotic property and all that. So these are wonderful products that we can really fly with, and I can assure you that the coming years is going to be very beautiful because of what is going to happen in the space of alternative medicine. So let's fly with this. Let's be able to talk confidently about the product we have. This is not, don't want to mention name, but this is not some of the rest. If it is some of the rest, I'm not going to be here. I'm here because I'm convinced of what value I'm getting from prescribing these two products. I have loads of testimony on my phone yesterday, day before yesterday, I can see forward of people using it and what will they keep saying. So thank you everybody. This is the conclusive part of my presentation. I appreciate everybody for listening, and I'm sure I've been able to impart one or two knowledge on reason why we should not be shy about what we are doing. This is going to just be the future of medicine, because there's going to be a new dimension. There's going to be a paradigm shift. The FlexNAS report has done what he has to do, but other reports are going to come. Maybe this is going to be the Rida's report. So things are changing, and we have to be part of the change. Thank you, and let's have a lovely day.
In order to get regular tips on health and general wellness, especially the natural way, please click on the subscribe button on the right side of this video. This will ensure that you also get notifications anytime a new video is posted on this channel.